Zarkov, your turn.
I take a half move, and if I can, crawl underneath the table.
Yep, sure. Go for it.
Alright, and then I cast Seal Wounds.
Okay.
Using 3 die because I need more HP.
You know things are going well and well and someone's cowering under a table.
So for every 5 points of overbleeds, I've got it's a threshold of 10. I can do an extra d10 plus my full power bonus.
Okay.
So I'll do this twice. 15 and 7. But I think I'll go back to full HP.
Yeah, seems like it. Okay.
Fuck you and your bullets.
Yeah. You can only cast that heal thing on yourself, though, isn't it? That's like the better one, if I remember.
No, it has a range. Okay.
Okay.
And if I ever bleed as well, I can affect more than one target sometimes. So.
Okay. Let me see. The strange cultist here is dead. This one here. This one here, wheels on the man who just, like, the woman who just lit, like, two of his fellows on fire and fires a full blast. And he hits you twice. So, Mira.
Yep. That deserves.
Quick question, Mark. Can I see these people's ankles?
Their ankles?
Yeah.
They're very far away. Yeah, you can, but I mean, if you're going to shoot at them, I'm going to give you, like, a minus 30 to hit their ankles, because that's, like, a hard shot.
And also, you're blind.
Yeah, the,
well, it's more lightning bolts.
He sees their presence through the warp, basically.
Yeah. Okay. I failed. The dodge.
Okay, so you get hit twice. No pen, and I hit you in the body. Yeah, so body.
So minus 5 for armor and minus 4 for toughness. So minus 9 all in all.
Okay, so 3 and 1, so minus 4.
Yeah, I'm down to 11 wounds.
Okay. Boone, your turn.
Right. So, semi-auto hellgun, the guy who dodged. I think it's this guy, right?
Yes.
Yep.
So that would be plus 20, I guess? Hellgun is just plus 10 by its own.
Yes. Well, semi-auto is just... Oh, yeah. So, yeah, correct. Because the hellgun has
and
that
red
dot
sight
shit.
Is only single
it's
shot.
It's only on single shots,
yeah.
So, at this guy here, right? Who dodged?
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, so you hit him. So you hit him... That was a semi-auto, was it?
Yeah.
So, 3 times. Yeah, he melts into paste. Our ash has 3 giant holes appear in his body. Alright, Flo, your turn.
Yeah, I'm gonna use this turn just to run.
Okay. And actually, Flo, make an awareness test for me. It's based on hearing, if that makes anything for you.
I don't think it makes a difference for me in particular. Oh, I'm unaware.
Yep, so never mind.
I'm just taking cover between these chairs.
So this strange cultist tries to summon the willpower not to be on fire.
Do they take points of damage, or is it just fatigue?
They take damage. It's not, for that watch, I don't care, because like your power armor alone is enough to ignore it most of the times.
Oh, okay.
Not to mention your toughness, so the only thing that happens to you is fatigue. But they're not fearless, and Space Marines don't really mind being on fire or really care as much. They don't react the same way, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So these guys, like, you know, they react when they're on fire. Let's put it that way. So 9 damage, only resisted by toughness and armor. Okay, is 2 damage, and he burns to death.
Yay!
That guy's dead. Ficus, your turn. And roll an awareness, Ficus, just like float.
Okay.
Run.
No.
Run, you fools.
Okay, never mind. Do what you will.
I'm going to run.
as fast as possible, which is 18.
Wouldn't it be best to win this way?
Maybe.
Yeah, I'd say go right about there.
I don't think he's beeline for the door as quickly as he can.
That's it, would it be around here-ish?
Remember, you can select your token and then use space to create
waypoint. Yeah, I've done that thing. I'm going to go 16, so I'm just behind Born, I think. Oh, screw it. I'll go my... Wait.
It doesn't work when I hold spacebar, nothing happens.
You like... Yeah, that's 17, the two things I did with my thing. You click your token, then press spacebar, then move it, and then, like, move it somewhere else.
Oh.
Yeah. Ooh. Alright, that's your turn. The strange cultist is dead. Victus, your turn.
Victus will aim and shoot at this fellow over here.
Which guy, sorry? This one? Okay. He tries to dodge.
No clamp for you.
He dodges.
Damn it!
I rolled a 1, actually. You shouldn't have said clamp.
Yeah, my bad.
You gave him the look now, what the fuck? Alright, this cultist wheels around with his last bit of ammo and fires it at Mira. And
fuck, it's a new round. Oh, fuck it, it's a new round as well.
Your turn, Mira.
Flame on again.
Flame on, I guess.
Yeah, I don't think that would be near the edge of that, like, if you angled it like that.
Yeah, that's like, aiming straight through.
Aiming straight through him. Do they have... Nope. They can't really get out, yeah, you're right. Alright, so just roll damage, because they can't really dodge. Okay, so 9 pound 3 is 5 damage. And the other one's 9 damage. Okay, and that they are on fire or not. This guy is on fire. The other guy is not. Alright, Zarkov, your turn.
Could I, like, crawl out of... underneath the table and run to the statue. I run 12, so.
I will say crawling out is like slow as shit, so until here, like everything is doubled, so till there is like 6 meters rather than 3, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
And then everything on is normal, okay.
So 6 and 5, that's 11, so I can just make it, yeah. I get into cover at the statue.
Mm-hmm. Strange cultist who's on fire. Still very much on fire. And he burns to death. Flamers are good against robes, who knew? Boone, your turn.
Yeah, I'm gonna shoot the last guy.
Okay. Did you by chance did you have a wife that got sold off into slavery?
No.
Oh, okay.
Fallout reference?
Yep.
Oh.
New Vegas to be precise.
Oh fuck.
How does he miss?
Sorry,
is it a jam?
No.
Okay.
Okay, Flo, your turn.
Keep on running. Actually. Yep.
Question, has Flo hit anyone this fight?
Nope, I jammed my gun. See ya.
Has Flo ever hit anyone?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's hit a few people. Yeah. Focus, your turn.
One guy's still alive, right?
Yep.
Barely.
Like, all barely. I've moved pretty far. I'm going to try sniping him. We'll see what happens. Oops, not damage, sorry.
Can I half aim and all that stuff for...
Yeah.
Plus 40. Okay. So I'll try. Yeah, he can't. Oh, he can't dodge. He hasn't dodged yet. He just got hit by fire. Nope. So roll damage with an extra d10 for the 2 degrees of success.
Well, we may as well use the one I just did, not just do my d10.
Yep.
How much HP does Boone have?
13.
Like, right now?
No, 9.
So 16 damage?
Dead son.
Yep.
Well, more than six, less than 16, but yeah, he's dead either way.
Oh, even more, because of the fact I've got the doing critical damage thing.
Oh yeah, you're right, yeah. He'll be dead either way. Alright, so you kill the last of them?
If I can, I try and heal up Mira and Boone, so I ask them to come near me.
So the well, I mean, you might not have the time to do that because the awareness test that we're doing for them, which they failed, they hear now as a bunch of other cultists come barging through the doors behind you.
Alright, back.
So you guys, like, can fight them, you can run, but I would suggest the run part because quite soon after they come through the door... This fellow comes with them. Followed by this guy. And the immense dark warrior gets a very long look at you and sort of like, you know, glowers with malevolence at you. And the man in the white robe, white and red robe, sort of shouts to his, you know, minions or followers, kill them! Alright, so, do you guys want to run or fight?
Yeah, running. Run. I shout Carly Mar back at them. Hey Mira, grab me. Here's.
Let him be an offering.
Are we doing turns to run or are we just running?
Mira picks Zarkov up and throws him at them. Take him!
Shoot him in the knee.
Yeah, pretty much. Because he made me fucking use the chain.
Hey guys, if I can get 400 XP, I can regrow my eyes. Alright.
Just dragging them. You've got to drag him along.
So as you guys start running, you just gather up there so I can like copy paste you if it comes to it.
Can I like do a sonition's check as I run?
Not really. It takes a bit of effort and patience.
Okay.
If you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So as you're running, the strange cultists start opening fire with their various weapons, and the immense, dark, and horrific warrior takes it a huge weapon from the side of his thing and starts firing at you. What seems more like cannon rounds than anything else, and the walls explode wherever his bull shells hit. And you guys barely manage to get out and run up to the... you know, you're running up the stairs and you can hear shouts behind you and they're very clearly following you.
Does anyone have a frag grenade?
Yeah, if you have a frag grenade or something, you could chuck it down the stairs and run.
I also have demolitions, if that helps.
You'd have to set those up. Right, you'd have to do demolitions check to set them and plant them, and then detonate them, so it would take too much time.
Actually, I don't. I have fire bombs. I thought I had those, but I think we left some. So I'm just gonna chug a flame grenade down the stairs.
Okay, we'll roll ballistics just to see if it doesn't scatter anyway weird.
It scatters
like you drop it on top of you or something.
Any bonuses from knowing demolitions?
Yeah, you can get a plus 10.
And that was the second time Phil wiped the party.
Oh God.
Okay, so
that is
a scatter, so roll 1d12,
can
and then,
I
like... Yeah, if you have a fate point.
I do. Oh my god!
He lights the Molotov cocktail and then tries to drink some and lights his face on fire. Alright, so roll 1d12 and then 2d10.
What would affect us, like, if this guy...
If it's anywhere between 10 and 12, and 4 and 6, it will bounce off a wall as you guys run it. Alright, so it bounces off a wall, and roll 2d10. And if you roll low on this... Okay, that's fairly low. Okay, so it's about... How far across was the wall? It was about 2 meters? So it bounces once that way, then it bounces once that way, then it bounces once that way. So, okay, unfortunately, the way you guys are running, let's say, okay, you were running up the stairs. Poignant question, who was at the back?
I am.
Okay, so Mira would have got hit. So roll the damage for fire. You can try and dodge Mira.
I thought the furthest person back was Zarkov.
I don't know, he was at the back of the group. Whoever's at the back gets hit.
Like, as soon as we reach the stairs, Mira would push Zarkov in front of her, you know, in front of
You're
her,
mistaken, you know, Zarkov.
Oh, I know. I'm ready with the flame at the back. I still have one round left.
Like, let's have the blind guy hold the back, you know.
I'm going to try to draw to you.
Okay, so you get hit, so roll the damage, focus.
Don't worry, it's not bad.
He says.
Fire bombs are only 1d10 plus 3.
And...
Mm-hmm. With a chance of lighting them on fire if they fail the agility test.
My agility is low.
Oh, it's only 12.
What's
guys.
The pen on him? Funny.
Firebomb is 6, so it's only 6.
6 10. Alright, so that hits your chest because AoEs always hit the chest.
Oh my god, this is going to be fucking horrible. So I have minus 9 from 5 on the chest, so it's going to go straight through. So okay. I just minus 4 from toughness.
Alright, so 8 damage, and then okay. Roll agility to not be on fire.
I rolled a jitter before he gets the damage.
Okay, so you'll be on fire.
And I took 8 damage.
Yep.
I'm down to 3 HP.
And you're on fire.
You know why this happened? It's because Ollie was like, chuck a grenade behind us. Why did I exactly listen to Ollie again?
I don't know. I don't know why you continually listen to Ollie.
Like, Bill, it's your own fault since you're listening to me. You can't blame me. But having suggestions and then following them.
And also,
next
it's kind
time
of weird.
I'm gonna throw you in front of it, Pippin. Just so you know.
Yeah, where's Firehead? He could have thrown himself on it.
Let's just say Zarkov was last, so Zarkov.
So luckily enough, as you make your daring escape out, Mira, you'll just gain 1 fatigue from the fire, but then you can jump into like one of the many bats or whatever or lobs on over your head. So it's not so bad, but you do gain 1 level of fatigue.
As soon as we're up there, I guess. Like I try and heal.
Well, there's still dudes running after you.
Alright, okay.
We still have to get out.
Get in the van and drive off.
No, we run.
You could rob the van, yeah. I mean, it's possible.
Like, does anybody have move ground wheel?
Yes.
Drive
ground
wheel.
I can drive.
Yeah, drive ground wheel.
Can anyone actually hot water it?
The keys are actually in the ignition, basically. So.
Oh, okay.
Lucky so, us. Boone, if you have the drive skill, go ahead and make a drive skill to get away.
Yeah, it's... It's only 37, so, well, we'll see.
By the way, I stay at the back.
I'll re-roll that.
Yeah, because otherwise you're going straight into the wall. It's like Boone's like, I'm trying, and he drops into the wall.
Oh, no.
Oh, Christ.
I guess whilst we're in the car, can I make a healer?
Yes, you can start making your heal test, yeah.
Alright, cool.
How much damage do we take from the crash?
Okay, so... I'm gonna say the car, like, you do get away, but, like, you bang the walls a couple of times, you smack into a few, you know, light posts and things like that, so everybody in the car make a toughness test, or you're gonna take impact damage.
Can I get the heal off first?
Knocked around. Yeah, you can do the heal as you, like, bundle in and he starts the car, basically, or the truck, so.
That goes off, and I get to affect an additional target, so would I, yeah, I would be in 10 meters from
the
right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, you just got me more.
I rolled a fucking 99. What's with these high ass rolls?
I have no idea, man.
Mira gets 11 HP. And Boone gets.
I think we should play Death Watch tonight with these rolls.
Boone gets 10 HP. That's before the impact damage.
I don't know. Do you have a lot of sacred unguents? Because it looks like you're going to need it.
I'll work on making some.
The toughness test, right?
Yep. Everybody make the toughness test.
Nope.
Fucked.
Did, George make it?
Not yet.
No, 1 second. It's toughness for what?
You jumped into the truck, then Boone like drove it through a couple of lampposts and things like that. So you're all getting like impact damage from being tossed around. Right.
Good question, Juan. Seal wounds doesn't mention anything about like you have to wait 6 hours, or is that just applied with healer, like only with healer?
It's generally applied with healer.
Okay, so I could spam seal wounds on people.
Technically, yes.
Alright.
Okay, so you guys take let me see. Impact damage, basically. And that is resisted by toughness and armor. So 11, and it's your body's armor. So everyone who failed the toughness, take that much and reduce it by toughness and armor.
So 11 minus that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah, take 2 damage.
Toughness 4. That's 9, so I take a 2, okay.
Okay, so as you bundle down the street, you guys can see some of the figures skate out of the thing and start shooting at you, but very quickly it becomes obvious they have no means of following you very rapidly, and they sort of give up. So you guys are... It's just a few hours after daybreak, let's say, 8 o'clock or so in the morning, and you guys have seen quite a lot of shit in one night, to say the least. And you've clearly uncovered something immense. So you're in the truck, trundling down a main road, and you sort of immediately connect and merge with a bunch of traffic going about doing other various things. So you're all in the back, Boone is driving, what do you guys want to do?
Hey, on the tech priest, can you raise the interrogator?
Interrogator!
Does the interrogator have... Is he psychic in any way, or...?
The interrogator?
Yeah.
Tyrus? Tyrus is not a psychic, no.
Oh, okay.
Right, so I use my Voxcaster to call up the interrogator.
Okay, so the interrogator is on the light of Alantaris in orbit around you. Takes a few minutes for you to get through the Vox communicator. The Vox officer, knows who you are quite well and connects you. So after about 10 or so minutes, you get a connection to Tyrus, and he just says, "Acolytes, report."
I pass the Vox to Victus.
As an interrogator, we have found... Would I, outside the game, would I say this is a chaos hideout or a heretics hideout?
A heretical cult of some kind, yeah.
Yeah, bad hideout.
How do they say heretic in Portuguese? I'm genuinely interested.
I really don't know.
Is there a word for heretic in Portuguese?
Erge.
Okay.
Yeah. It's almost heretic.
Hideout.
Or, nothing like it, but yeah.
Heretic, he said.
And I give him the location of the place. We have found, and I give a description of the big... mutated Adeptus Astartes guy, and okay. I await orders.
Yeah, actually, I'm genuinely curious, Mira. You got lit on fire by Ficus. Is there any lingering annoyances with that?
Maybe.
He literally like took it out, lit it, and then like dropped it as he was throwing it, and it landed right in your face. So.
That might be.
You're not pre anymore.
Dude, lit you on fire.
If I'm come to it, I might be throwing people around a bit.
Right. Okay. So, interrogated Tyrus listens very intently to everything you have to say, and never once butts in or asks you a question until you finished telling the very long and laborious story about what your investigation, the man with the strange marking on his hand, the weird kidnappings, and then the giant corrupted individual. Like immense dark warrior guy you saw. And he listens intently for a long time, and then he just says, these are grave tidings indeed. Please return to the spaceport and return to the light of Alantaris. We have much to discuss.
Well, it's gonna get bombed.
I ask if We have not completed yet the Queen's mission. Are we to go as soon as possible to the
port? He just says report to the spaceport immediately and a loader will be provided for you. Things have escalated now.
I tell Gabriel to, as soon as he passes a cab, to wave it so we can get there as fast as possible.
Aren't I driving?
Yeah, but you're driving.
I actually want you to pull over, call a cab so we can get there.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll do that then.
If I can, I say, Victus, may I have a word with the interrogator?
I passed the thing, the com. I keep forgetting names today.
Vox?
The Vox.
I say, boarding interrogator, I feel that the presence of such a creature has corrupted in me in some way. I feel that I should be purified once aboard the Light of Antares.
I can purify you some holy fire and show him my Molotov.
Yeah, he repeats the same thing. Return to the light, and we will discuss the next, next part of your objective.
And then I'll hand it back to Victus if he,
Yeah, so we held a cab. I'll get the 10 drones.
So ready. you ditched the transport vehicle, yeah?
Yes.
Okay. So you ditched the transport vehicle and, hire a cab and start making your way through the streets of Verthand again. Back to the spaceport near the center of the town, or the center of the city. So it takes you, like, maybe an hour or two through the traffic and the winding corridors and, roads of the place to finally make your way there. And once you're there, a number of inquisitorial stormtroopers immediately identify who you are. And then, escort you to an Arvis lighter, and you're brought back up to the Light of Alantaris again. Let me see. You guys are all there yet?
Yep.
Okay, so transport from the surface back up to your cruiser takes a few moments, or sorry, a few minutes, maybe 20 or so. And you finally dock, and then after all the docking procedures, another 20 minutes or so, you're brought to the various ascenders and other transport through the cruiser to Interrogator Tyrus's sanctum again. All in all, maybe about 4 hours or more since you escaped from the supposed chaos cult. Alright, so as you come through the door, you can see that Tyrus is like intently talking over a Vox communicator to someone while siphoning through a great many papers. And as soon as you get closer, you can see that a large number of strange symbols and stuff seems to be what he's looking through. And it seems he's intently looking for the strange symbol that you found on this, the back of the man's hand and trying to identify what it was. So feel free to approach or do whatever you want to do.
I pass my old...
Oh, don't.
I pass my drawing to Victus.
And I pass it to Interrogator Tyrus, and I say that we have found those symbols as well. I point to the symbol on the... you mean the snake symbol?
The snake symbol thing, yeah.
Yeah, I point and I say we have found shells with that symbol on the hand.
Yes, he knows. That's why he's investigating it. And he looks into it and he looks up at you and says, yes, I found no leads as to the meaning of this symbol. It's not something that the Inquisition, or at least myself, seems to be aware of. I put in requests through the Astropathic Choir to contact the other Inquisitors and Interrogators on the... Inquisitorial Black Fleet currently in orbit to see if they know anything about it, but it could take some time before I hear anything back. Please, Victor, sit down and tell me more in detail about what you saw. And, he tells you to take a seat while the others, stand around or whatever. And you go into more detail about what you saw. You describe the warrior and stuff, I guess.
Yeah, I showed the picture that it was Mirren
draws like the wind, apparently.
I show him the drawing.
You saw him the drawing of the statue you saw and everything else?
Yeah, give both pictures.
Yeah, the statue as well.
Okay,
forgot
so he
about
goes,
that one.
he pours over them, and he looks, you know, he immediately, his face darkens, and he grows quite grim as he looks over them all. And he says, it seems, I didn't, no, he just sort of looks in disbelief, and he goes, I didn't believe it could be true. I knew there was something afoot here, but, the Inquisitorial fleet and the Lord Inquisitor, I didn't believe them when they said that this planet was corrupted as much as it is, but the proof now sits before me. And he just sort of looks over it again and, you know, goes back to the symbol. And he says, it all goes back to this symbol for some reason. We need to discern what this cult is and what it means, but the presence of a corrupted Astartes is dangerous, to say the least. And he just sort of looks up at you and says, yes, it's true. Even the vaunted space marines of the Emperor can be corrupted. This knowledge cannot leave you. Do you understand? No one else is to know of his presence on this world. Is that understood?
I know.
I caught on my tongue. Done.
Bit much, but sure. You're already blind. If you don't want to talk again, I don't think anyone will complain. So he just sort of nods grimly and he says, we must know more about this symbol. It all seems to go back to House Holbrook as well. If what you're saying is true, then Dark seems to be a key member of this cult. And then he sort of sifts through some papers again and takes out a data slate and hands it to you, Victus, and says, did any of the men in the room, men or women in the room, or sorry, the men in the room, because he's only a man, look anything like this man? And he shows you a picture of a man, which appears to be the only picture recording they have of Lord Dark Holbrook, who's the son. And Victus, you can immediately tell that the man in the red and the red and white robes who was preaching looks like this man, except as if he aged several years and got, you know, drawn lines of, you know, age on his face, if you know what I mean. In the space of like 3 years, it looked like he aged about 30, if you know what I mean.
I say, interrogator, it seemed that the orator of the heretical cult seemed to be this one, but much older.
All right, he nods and says, yes, it does seem that House Holbrook is at the heart of all this then. He turns back to you and says, did you have any luck with the Queen's mission to infiltrate House Holbrook?
We heard rumors about Dark Holbrook kidnapping scam.
Mm-hmm.
And we were tracking down those kidnapping groups and followed that lead to the
bathhouse and everything. Okay. So he nods and says, yes, it seems they are very much at the heart of this then. You'll need to get inside their bastion. I believe it's our only source of direct information now. I'll inform the other inquisitors who are currently in orbit about this, you know, what's occurred on the world. I don't know what their actions are going to be, but if things aren't allied soon, I fear that grave actions may need to be taken to contain this, especially if it is an outbreak of what I believe it is. If it's some sort of chaos heretical outbreak, things could get very very difficult very quickly. You'll need to infiltrate the house. The only way I can see that you can do that is it's a bastion, so it'll be very hard to infiltrate. However, there are some upper platforms in the higher echelons of the tower that are landing pads for private shuttlecraft and other things used by the house to ferry their nobles around the world. Orbital scans indicate that these landing bays are closed and that no current lighter craft of any kind are inhabiting them. I'm giving you access to an armed Arius lighter craft, or Arvus lighter craft, to take you down there, as well as some breaching explosives to break through the armored doors. You're to infiltrate the building and find out anything you can, and if anyone is still in there alive, you're to take them captive. Is that understood? If possible, if they're too far gone, you're to purge them. Is it understood?
Yes.
All right, so he starts writing up some manifest details, and he hands it to you, and basically he's given you leave to take from the armory one high explosive melta bomb. Okay, so you can get a melta bomb, and then for basically breaching doors, And then on top of that, you guys can request any additional ammo or anything you want for free. Just if it's normal ammo, anything else you want to buy, you can do that as well. So he just turns to you and says, Victus, this is of paramount importance. You understand the fate of this world is in the balance now.
I'm nodding, I say, of course. As soon as I saw those grotesque figures, I knew this had to be solved okay. Without problems. I have a little question for you, Warren.
Mm-hmm.
Will they also be able to give us manacles and sleeping drugs?
Yes, you can take as much of that shit as you want, yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so he comes up to you, puts a hand on your shoulder, and says, dark times lie ahead, my friend. Go in strength. And remember, the Emperor protects, and he sort of rushes off to get his troopers and everything together so he can go storm that bathhouse, and he leaves.
As I interrogate, can I have a moment of your time?
Oh yeah, before he leaves, he'll turn to you and say, make it quick, Zarkov, I have things to do, and he sort of leads you over here to speak in private.
I say, like, he actually, like, the first time ever physically, he's like crying, you know, like just my mind, it feels so corrupt and tainted due to the presence. Is there anything can be done about this? I feel that I might harm the members of the squad.
Like, he just puts a hand on your shoulder again, like he did with Victus, and says, I know the burden you carry is great, my friend. To deal with the warp in such a manner is not something I would put on anyone lightly, but your team needs you as much as I do right now. If it is indeed true that a chaos cult has infiltrated Thadia Primaris and has, you know, gone so ingrained as to infiltrate a house as noble as House Obrook, they will need your speciality in the days to come. Is that understood? You must steal your soul in the name of the Emperor and do your duty.
Alright. I thank you, Interrogator. And then just only nods his head.
He just looks at you for a lingering moment, like as if he was doubting your, fortitude, and then he just sort of nods and says, Emperor be with you, and he walks off.
Alright. And I ask Mira to walk back to the group.
Mira is just your bitch now.
No, I
pay Mira to be my bitch, okay?
So you guys head to the armory and Armsmaster Holt, or Hasselt again. To get whatever you need for what's coming ahead. So he's already prearranged the organization of the large Melta Bomb, so who wants to take possession of that?
I will. I won't.
I think it should be me. I have demolitions.
Yeah.
Warren, I'm going to ask for 3 good manacles.
Yep,
and I'm looking for drugs that would knock out people.
Yep, so they immediately, like, prepare the shackles and give you, like, a box of them and anything else you want. Let's see, drugs. Drugs, drugs, drugs. It always comes down to drugs, isn't it? Okay, let's see. They'll just give you a drug called Slab, which is commonly used by the Imperium to keep prisoners locked down, if you know what I mean. So okay. they give you 5 doses of Slab, if anyone wants to take that.
I'll take...
I guess I say I fear for the safety of my squad, Victus, and I will put my life in your hands, and if I can, I request an explosive collar and put it on myself and then give Victus the trigger.
Yeah, sure, you can do that.
Don't be corrupted by this bullshit.
I accept and I give valor to your sacrifice for the Emperor.
And pull the trigger.
And I dropped the remote. Oops.
I guess I'll take 2 of the doses, George.
2 of the doses? Okay. I think that everyone should have 1 dose. That way, if we need to hit 5 at the same time, everyone has a dose and
okay.
We don't need to...
Cool.
So after a while, Adept Almala, who is Interrogator Tyrus's like seneschal, comes through the door and, you know, looks you over and says, "Your lighter has been prepared. It will depart whenever you need it to. It's been armed as the interrogator requested it to be armed. So it has two side-facing autocannons that could be controlled from the inside if you need them." Okay.
Will we be the ones operating the...
No, there's a driver, a co-pilot, and two gunners, but you can take control of the guns if you want to at any point, but you're literally just going to land on a landing pad just outside the upper area, if you know what I mean.
I'm going also to inquire for parachutes. I think that would be important.
There's parachutes on the lighter.
Oh, okay. Then, never mind.
Just a question.
A charm is like mostly like a personal thing you just find, or like, you know, it could be like an idol to the Emperor you believe is holy.
Okay, after I prove myself on this mission, my explosive collar will be my charm. I'll deactivate it, of course, and carry it around.
It would have to be something like holy or symbolic, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I guess I will. Can I request for two more canisters or
canisters of flamer? Yeah.
Yes.
What's a good ammo for using in a sniper rifle?
Well, you have a laser rifle, don't you?
Oh, god damn it.
So it'll be some sort of laser energy pack.
You could get a hunting rifle and put that, like, Georgie's Manstopper rounds, I think. And can you get a crack rounds standard for, like, normal weapons?
Can't get crack rounds for snipers. Or long losses, if that's what you mean.
No, I meant, like...
Kraken round. I think Kraken rounds are an Astartes pattern.
Okay.
I don't think they're normally built for humans now.
If we can we like fit pick recorders to like all of our
anything armors? Extra other than ordinary ammo or like the manacles and doses of slab they gave you'll have to pay for. So
even pick recorders.
Yes.
They can't see the logic in giving them. It was for free.
Everything in the Imperium is at a premium, man. You gotta pay for shit.
I think we should stock up on grenades, by the way.
George, if you can you get us at least a picked recorder so, you know, we don't have the...
They mostly give you the salary just to, like, you know, buy shit and survive, you know, to do the Emperor's work. It's not to get rich. They don't pay you to actually earn anything. They pay you to, you know, go to worlds and, like, survive in them so you can complete your mission, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
I'm checking for the pick recorder.
It's a 100. It's 1 kilogram.
Yeah, but I'm going to get the good one.
Oh, okay. What's the difference if you make it good?
The normal one, I think it's black and white. The others have color.
Yeah, normal pick recorders are black and white.
Yes, I hit Bermuda's autogun with my technical knock.
Yep, it's unjammed.
Hooray for the magic of technology.
Some of you are still kind of hurt, so you might want to like do some Medicaid tests and
I'll
then
do
replenish.
Some Medicaid.
You can replenish your Medicaid thing here for free, they don't mind doing that.
Okay, I do that.
Wow, something for free?
I'll heal people up first and then refresh it. Right, so who's the worst off?
I could do psychic healing if you wanted.
No.
The ship explodes. Okay,
I'm missing 5 points.
He opens the portal to the warp, you all get sucked in and die.
I cast heal on myself first. Yeah, cool. It's 1d5.
Do I need to make an ingrid check for the picture recorder? For the good picture recorder?
No. They'll have a good picture recorder.
Okay, I'll buy it then.
Mm-hmm.
It was 20 with the medkit. Yeah, it was. Okay, that was for Mira, because I messed up his face so bad.
Which one? Oh.
Mira.
What's your intellect, Phil?
Now 54.
So you gain 5 wounds back.
So I'm back to 4.
Could speed this along a lot more, like...
So now, 10 plus, or does it not go down each time?
It goes down as per the normal rules for the medkit thing, but you can always just replenish them again, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah. No, I mean, like, the what I'm rolling for the next
person.
Oh,
I don't... Yeah, it's minus 10 yet for an next person. There you go. So whoever that was for gets 5 back.
Me.
Let's say Boone. Why the hell were you over there? I couldn't see health.
Because Zarkov... Sorry, no, I moved because Zarkov said he was healing himself, so I moved.
Flo hears, okay, I'm gonna heal, and she just starts lagging at the other side of the room.
Hey, it saves lives. My life.
Warren, can I get a couple of frag grenades for free?
They'll give you some normal grenades for free, like 3 at the most each. So.
Okay.
Right, that's for Boone. Now it's minus 10.
Does anyone have any suggestions of psychic shit? Like psychic items that would help? Like, I have a psychic focus and that's it, so...
Did I end up hurting myself with that minus 10?
No, it's only if it's 3 degrees or more.
Okay, shall I try minus 20 on you, Zarkov?
No, I'm fine. I'm only one off.
Okay.
I could just, like, seal wounds everyone. Get them to tip-top shape.
They don't want you to cast psychic shit needlessly.
I know, but I like doing it, so...
We noticed.
Well, I come and stand next to you and let's go off into the corner.
Oh, you actually want... Do you want to top it up?
Do it. May as well be full.
I will use one die. It goes off, and you gain 1d10 plus 5, so 6 at minimum.
Just like the reaction if everybody ran over who went down into the corner.
So I'm at full now. Crap.
Sorry, that would be one less. Fine.
I needed 2.
Yeah, so yeah.
George just starts singing, it's beautiful.
Oh god.
There's murder on the dance floor. You better not kill the groove.
This is an inspirational. Song of the Emperor.
Don't start turning to Dankrid, please.
Well, I can sing.
You know what happened to Dankrid, don't you?
Yes.
Like towards the end, he started to sing really well, and then you all died.
Yeah.
But I always sang well. It's only when I start to sing bad that's going to hit the fan.
I see.
Okay, joining in. Ah.
But you think it's good because you're so bad a singer, you can't tell.
So basically, if I begin singing good, there's something wrong.
Guys, we should buy some hallucinogenic grenades.
Please do, those things are hilarious.
Please.
Yeah.
Especially when you fumble and they land right at your feet.
Scatter.
So wait, how many things would I have to get from free for them?
Standard grenades. So like hallucinogenic grenades are not standards. So.
Yeah.
Can we get them here, though?
Yeah, you can get them. Just,
They're 40 a pop.
Okay, yeah. I buy 2.
Yes.
While I'm here, would I be able to buy an overcharge pack to put on my LAS rifle?
Yep.
It apparently cost me 15.
Anything else?
I'll get a couple more. Grenades for free, firebomb grenades, just restack up. Well, I mean, I couldn't see any of the, like, Laz special ammo anywhere. Is that in one of the...
It's probably in the Makarian.
Yes. Book.
I'll take a look, 2 seconds.
Thank you.
Everything we're looking at is generally in the Makarian, if you're buying so.
Use the 4-web one.
Just saying, Warren, whenever, like, you throw a grenade or, like, fire an explosive weapon or thing. If it jams, there's a table on which you roll.
I know.
Get +1 to the weapon's damage now for only halving my total thing. A clip. Hooray.
I don't seem to be able to find any last weapon stuff. It's mostly shells and bolts.
Look at those weapons. Or a projectile are the best. That's the Space Marine using LAS guns.
There's not many LAS ones.
But...
Well, I mean, like, I'm a priest of Solex, so I just love the light things, so I just thought, screw it, let's go laser all the way.
There's
flame bombs.
There's literally nothing.
So, what are we doing now?
I'm looking for if there's any psychic shit that will aid.
There's a psychic drug.
What does it do?
I think it corrupts you, but gives you more psychic shit. Let me see.
Got 10 firebombs now, guys. Don't worry.
Wow.
It's all going to be great.
Warren, next time something like that happens, can I please get a reaction roll of a d10, and if I roll 10, can I kick the fucking thing away?
Is that a rule? Anywhere?
Probably not.
No,
then it'll be dodge, so. Yeah. I might like, if you dodge, I might allow you to pick it up and throw it back at, like.
Like... It's probably gonna happen. Something like that.
Can you throw ballistics and then blows up in your hand?
Can't seem to find anything for the psychic drug. Anyway.
You should buy a jump pack, it's only 2,000.
Yeah, but you need a skill for that.
Oh shit, yeah.
And I'm close to getting that skill.
I planned a submarine and forgot that you needed the skill for it.
I think I will run one or two ranks. No, just one or next rank. I can get the jump pack. Or use it.
There's a truth serum in Dark House. It's 130 if you want to buy it.
There's a what?
Truth serum, 130 it costs.
Yeah, if you want. It's worth buying it, I'll take a dose.
The subject resistant interrogation increases to minus 50. I think. True serum of all types. Affected after 2d10 minutes. The drug amounts.
Guys, nearly done buying whatever.
Yeah, I am. I'm just making sure like there's nothing.
Okay, well, I'm just gonna continue. If there's anything in like post. You want to try and buy? We'll presume you bought it on the way there, okay?
Alright.
Until we land. Okay, so you guys are once again escorted to the Arvis lighter in the bay, which has been prepared for you. Here, you guys board it, and the pilot, the co-pilot, and the two gunners nod to you or salute as you enter. The bay is depressurized, and... there we go. Door is open, and your Arvis lighter once again zooms out into space and speeds down towards Verithand. So, in a few minutes, as you guys are going down, Zarkov, roll a willpower test for me.
Alright. Any modifiers?
Nope, just flat.
Alright. Quite a lot.
Okay, so you can feel an overwhelming sense of doom coming from the planet now that you didn't feel before, if you know what I mean. It's like as if doom has been suffused into the people of the planet. All right.
Yeah, I guess I'll say the people of this planet, they weep.
I slap Zarkov and I say, "Hold it together, man. We can do it."
You do not know what I see.
Show him the control that you've got for his collar. I'll soon do what you say. Victus.
I give him a low stick.
Okay.
Smoking down.
So after a while, you zoom down through the planet and land near the upper docking bay of one of the outer areas of the Bastion. So your ship lands like here after a few moments, and you guys get out, and the door into the main Bastion is over that way. So I presume you get out. Do you tell the pilots to stay in the ship at the, you know, say where they are, or do you tell them to fly off and wait for them to contact you, or what do you want to do with them?
They could just wait for us.
I think they should be flying around slightly.
Because imagine if we are in a room with windows, they can vault to the window and aid us shooting through the window.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so you tell, you tell them to fly around and hover and wait, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wait for instructions.
So you guys get to the door, and there are immense adamantine security doors that have been locked, but you've given a melter bomb for this exact purpose, so who wants to set up the bomb?
I do.
Somebody set us up the bomb. We just double check
what demolitions is actually under. It's intelligence, probably,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. I noticed from the Lorgath.
Do I get any bonuses at all?
It's been pre-designed for breaching, and you're quite familiar with it, so I got a plus 20. Yeah. Nice. Ooh. Okay. So you set the bomb up quite well, and you guys go back a few meters to take over, yeah? Alright, yep. So...
No, Emperor protects me.
Okay. Bomb goes off, and a very large... 2 meter or so hole in the door has been completely cut clean through, and you guys go in, I guess, like with guns up, checking corners and stuff, and enter in. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when you get inside, it's this. So you guys are all over here, so you can see that. Yeah.
Yep.
Yep. So you breach through the door there. It's about 2 meters wide hole in the large door like that you managed to get through. You guys fan out and search the area, and before you there's a large gate, which appears to be locked in the like inner courtyard of the entrance, and that's all you can see. And the floors are dusty and ill-maintained, it looks like no one has been in here for a very long time.
Do the tech use this gate open?
It's security to open the door.
I've got security.
Do you have a multi-key?
I don't think I do.
You can buy that in post if you want to, or someone can buy for it.
Sure. How much does it cost?
You knew you'd be breaking in entering, so.
Yeah, that's true. How much does it cost?
150.
I'll find it. Wow. Wow. Okay.
I'll just say I bought it for you. I've got 500.
Yeah, I was going to buy it. But...
George is bankrolling this group.
If you want to pay 1,650, I can be able to do sign distance checks looking for any psychers around.
No.
How much?
1,650.
Sorry, you're saying that number too quickly, and I'm by the
English. 1,650.
Okay.
It's most of his money, yeah.
Yeah.
No. The maybe later, but not today.
Okay, so Victus bought a multi-key, and Flo can use it? You bought it?
Yes.
Okay. So that gives me a plus 10 to the security test?
I think it's plus 30.
Damn.
What a multi-key, they're very good, let me just try. Yep, plus 30 security test to open locks.
Hell yeah.
And you needed it. Yeah. Alright, so the door clanks open and the gate opens and you guys are free to walk in now. So, feel free to walk.
After you.
Presume you guys are going in small squad tactics, checking corners and things. Yeah,
Do you want me to roll
like
small
FBI.
Tactics?
Roll anything you want, it doesn't matter. It's me.
Roll your...
Imperialis, for help.
I get a dose of spook. It is... 350, fuck me.
I guess there's another gate here.
Yep, that's another gate there that will require a security lock.
Just checking the other way as well.
Do I learn anything from my tactical.
Oh yeah, you know small squad tactics. Boone knows them offhand because he was in the military anyway. So you guys are like fairly close together. I'll do it like similar to Shadowrun. You guys will get +2 to your initiative if you get into combat while you're in like this squad formation, if you know what I mean, checking corners and shit.
Should we try and unlock some gates?
Yeah. Let's try to unlock this one.
Can I shoot the lock off?
You could, but it wouldn't be very solid.
Well, we just blew a hole in this place.
True.
Warren, I take a burst of spook.
You have to remember, this place is very big, you know, it's a giant bastion, so unless anyone was very close by, like within the next 2 or 3 rooms, they probably didn't hear it.
Okay.
Backs of it.
Victus buying everything for him.
Yep.
You're like a guy that won the lottery, Victus, and everyone's like, yeah, can you buy me a car?
Yep. Did you succeed to open the gate?
Yeah, did you succeed to open the gate, actually?
I didn't try.
There's one right there, yeah.
What, here?
Yeah, right there. Do you see it?
No, it looks like a wall to me.
Oh, if you
this looks like a gate.
Yeah, if you zoom in a bit closer, there's another gate there. It's just
Oh god, okay. Yeah, it's not something on the floor. Alright.
Yeah.
So, the spook has no effects, but I roll on a +20 to any of the psychic phenomena table.
Okay, well, deal with it.
5 hours.
Good job, man.
Yep.
Yay!
You fucking fit.
Yeah, so, Flo handily opens the door, the gate. You guys continue on.
Can we just leave Zarkov over
Can we just leave Zarkov in the corner?
He doesn't know where to go. Stop following us.
I'm following the wall, man. Like, I can hear you guys walking.
Yeah, just imagine Ficus just goes up and slaps him and goes, no, bad dog, bad dog. Right, so there's another gate here, yeah.
Is this the scale one? The walls?
Yes.
God damn. Junior 4-meter thick walls.
It's a big giant royal noble mansion house fortress. What do you think it's going to be like? Okay, so you get into this room, and everyone make an awareness test for me.
Alright.
Let's see if I roll the one again, and if where fucking
it's based on here, and in case anyone's interested.
Oh yeah, I'd pass.
Okay. So Zarkov's in the room as well.
Yeah, I would be like in the corner.
So Zarkov, you could have sworn you hear murmured talking coming from a floor or two above you. It looks like that, because there's stairs that go up, if you know what I mean. So
Zarkov feels he's going slightly insane, so he just keeps it to himself.
The stairs go from here to here, and then they go up to another level from here to here. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So if you guys want to head up, you can do it stealthily, or you can run up. It's like up to you.
Stealthily.
Stealthy, small squad.
Zarkov is very confused about this, unless someone wants to like literally drag his ass over there.
Nope, he can stay there.
We'll leave him downstairs.
Right,
you're rolling on douchebag table straight away, right? So
No, I don't roll it on it. I roll a +20 on it.
It's probably
like I roll with a +20, that's all.
Alright, so you guys make your way up, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to go to stairs, move your tokens to here, because this is a multi-layered map, so like it'll progress as you move up. Is Zarkov literally been left down ground, or what's Victus and Zarkov doing?
He can walk.
Victus is be right back. Oh, he's back.
Yeah.
All right.
What happened? Sorry.
They all left me downstairs.
Yeah. So if you want to go up the stairs with them, Victus, you have to go up this way, then this way, then this way, or this way, this way, this way. Okay. So you guys get to there. Okay. So
did
you're.
Did we bring Zarkov?
Is Zarkov gonna go up on his own, or?
Like he will follow the wall like this, and then like if he walks into the stairs, he would go around the, and then if hear the squad talk about going upstairs, and he would follow these up.
Okay, well, you're over there, they're over there, okay.
Yep.
Right, okay, so as soon as you guys get up, you see the following. Yeah, Zarkov, you would have come up here, actually. Sorry.
Okay.
Okay, now wait. Just stay where you are, because like as soon as you come up, you're going to see the following. So you guys come up, and you see these guys here. And in the other room, just to the side of you, you hear what the murmured talking was, because none of you tried to listen to it.
Oh, God.
Right, so the second you come up, the Chaos Cultists who were murmuring and talking to themselves immediately just get up and, like, hiss at you, and the immense Dark Warrior turns around and goes, saved me the trouble, and he takes out his bolt gun and starts laughing at you, and Karrick just looks at you and squares his eyes.
Can I do a sonic like, I guess I feel the presence of, like, this.
Yeah. Massive. If you do it very quickly, sure.
Don't we get +2 to this?
Yeah, you gain +2 because of your small squad tactic thing.
Nope. Wow.
Jeez. Yes.
Would he still feel like me trying to probe him?
Yes, he would know.
Alright.
Oh, so 16 then.
My macro is wrong. It should be a 5 instead of a 3.
So, wait, would I get in...
Just change your... Yeah, you would get the... No, you wouldn't get the small thing because you're not in the squad. They're over there. Right. So anyone else add, like, 2 to your thing in the turn order if you haven't already done it? And I'll start rolling for these guys.
And the only one who doesn't get the +2 is Sarkov.
If he's going to keep doing warp douchebaggery, then, like...
Yeah.
What, man? I'm trying to save our lives. At least I haven't TPK'd the party, Bill.
I know.
Oh.
You got one already. You're fucking the first time with this group.
Yeah, true, but like, haven't got one yet, again.
I haven't got one yet, again.
Yep.
English is hard.
Hey, man, I speak good English.
Okay, everybody's on it. Yeah. Alright.
And the Space Marine goes before everyone.
Oh, shit. Only now I see the Dark Warrior.
Okay, so, Boone, you come up the door and you see a fucking horrific war. Actually, the only people who can see him right now are Mira and Boone. So, on your next turn, depending upon where you. Well, when it gets to him, you'll have to test fear. So, Boone, what do you want to do? Your psyche hasn't, you know, come to grasp with the horrible warrior in front of you yet, talking to Karrick in the corner there.
Okay, can I half move and throw a grenade?
Yes.
Okay, so I half move up to there.
Oh, if it fucking, like, goes somewhere else and hits the entire rest of us.
I'm gonna throw a hallucinogenic.
Okay.
But not in there, because they'll probably resist it.
Like, I don't even know how they work, to be honest, but yeah.
I'll throw it here. That's like, yeah, I'm gonna be in range of it because I can only throw it 9 meters, 10 radius.
What is the range of a hallucinogenic grenade?
10.
All right.
Yeah. 10. Yeah. So these kinds of grenades induce a variety of short-lived psychological states and delusions. Anyone within 10 meters of a detonating hallucination grenade will succeed on a difficult -10 toughness test, or be overcome with delusions and hallucinations for 1d10 rounds. Whilst affected, on the character's turn, roll 1d100. On a 50 or less, the character may act normally. On a 51 to 75, the character runs around screaming in response to some perceived witness. On a 67, the character attacks the close, blah, blah, blah. We'll use the optional rules, because they're more fun.
Table.
Yeah. Alright, okay, so where do you throw it, sir? Okay, well, roll ballistics, anyway. And you can throw it your strength bonus times 3, so...
Yeah, so 9, I guess.
Yeah.
But just flat ballistics?
Yep. Yep, lands exactly where you said it would did. So, 10 meters from there.
Yeah.
It's gonna hit you as well, I think.
Yeah, it will.
Okay, so it'll hit those three and you, okay.
Yeah.
So, make a toughness -10 test for me.
I'm gonna fail this, but whatever.
You have a fight point. So good.
Clamp. clamp.
Okay. Now roll 1d100, and if it's 50 or below, you aren't affected. If it's above, then something else will happen.
Clamp.
Okay, so you're not affected for this turn, okay?
Nice.